So wait a second. You're telling me I can test drive one of the best cinema cameras in the world, and it's not gonna cost me a dime? Those of you that are watching the channel know that I love the Arri Alexa. I've actually done a number of videos on the Arri Alexa. If you wanna check it out, I'll put links down below and up around here, I'll pop them out through the video. And one of the things that I just love about the Arri's experience is I always say this, the Arri, it's kind of priced like the Lamborghini, but it works like a truck. It is a fantastic, utilitarian, beautiful piece of equipment. You know you're always gonna get a fantastic image from Arri's, but the other thing about them that make them so good is they are so practical, so tough. And while I've done a number of videos on how to build an Arri, one of the things that I thought I should touch back on because it's an important part of the process is the amazing support and the system and infrastructure that exists that Arri has built even outside of the camera. And what I wanted to do today is tell you and start to show you some of those tools that exist in the Arri website online and how those tools, if you are working with an Alexa, can help you maximize your system. One of these things, if you've ever worked with an Alexa, you know they are beautiful, but it is expensive. Even to rent one costs a lot of money. And Arri has been great in realizing that these are not cameras that most of us own. Most of us rent it, we have it for a certain amount of times. And the Arri company has created an incredible line of support based around this whole concept, which means that you actually have ways to test drive and implement a lot of stuff regarding your Arri before you ever get it in your hands. This makes you more efficient and helps you make your day so much better. It's one of the things that I love about the Arri and I use the system. So what I wanna do today is let's go ahead, let's jump over the computer and let me start to show you how the Arri online software system can help you maximize this absolutely beautiful and amazing camera. All right, let's go. Okay, so here we are at the computer. And what I wanna do now is just to really dive in here on the internet to show you all the cool tools that Arri has available to you here online. Now, I'm not gonna be able to get into everything because it's so deep, but I do wanna start off showing you a couple tools right off the bat. If you're thinking about renting an Arri just to know what the system can do, let's go and take a look and see what we got. So let's jump over here to the website. So if you look here, I'm at Arri.com, and it's pretty easy to get there if you look at it. The first thing we're gonna do is we just wanna come over here to the Learn and Help. Couple menu deep, I'll click on that. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna come down here, there's a lot of great tools here. I'm gonna come down to Camera Workflow, click on that. And then once I come down here, I'm gonna come down just one more time, and now what I wanna do is I wanna come to Tools and Apps. And one thing I would recommend, guys, is go ahead and check out everything on the Arri site. There's so many great tools. No one video is gonna be able to show you everything you can do, but it's a really great resource for you as an independent filmmaker to get not only knowledge of the Arri system, but honestly, filmmaking in general. It's really gonna up your game. I find it to be an invaluable resource. I come here frequently because there's so much cool stuff on it. All right, now, if you look at the tools and apps, there's some really, really great things here. We have a frame lines and lens illumination tool, formats and data rate calculator, a LUT generator, an Arri look library app, camera simulators, Arri raw converters, Arri color tool, meta extracts. You can explore all these different things. Now, what I wanna do is go in the ones that I think right off the bat, if you are an independent filmmaker looking to start getting and dipping your toes and playing with Arri, the things that right off the bat are you're gonna wanna look and play with, even if you don't have the camera in your system. And the first one is this, I love the camera simulators. So let's go ahead and click on the camera simulators. And what's great about this is it lets you go and you can see all of the big boys here. We have the Alexa Mini LF, the Alexa LF, and our Arri'S simulator. You know, you can see all the different Alexas that we have here. Then it has a classic simulator. Now, what's great about this is if you are an operator who maybe this is your first time really getting a chance to do a hardcore shoot with the Alexa, this gives you a chance to go in there and dabble with the program. Or let's say you've used an Alexa before in the past, but it's been a while, you just wanna freshen yourself up so you're not on set, kind of fumbling around. This gives you those awesome options there and you can really play in it. So I, you know, have been using the Alexa Mini LF, so let's go in there and look at that simulator. So if I click on the Mini LF here, it gives me an option. I'm gonna open it in full screen mode because I think that's pretty cool. Right? Okay, so here it blows up and I get to see now the Alexa Mini this is exactly what it looks like when I'm actually shooting with this on the camera itself. And I love this because it feels so similar to what we go. So I can click on it. Like, let's say if I click on my frames per second, I can click on that. I can use my scroll wheel just like on the viewfinder on the Alexa Mini and scroll through it. If I want to get to the view that I like, I can get there. I click on that. I'm good to go. Same thing with shutter. I click on my shutter. I can go to different shutter angles if I want to get different shutter angles. I'll try 180. Why not? I can do ISO. And, you know, dial in my own white balance. If I want to hit my NDs, I can go pop in my NDs right here as well as the front. Very, very useful. Now, this is really, really nice to see and get that feel. But what I really like this simulator a lot is it allows me to go into the menu. So I can jump in the menu here, and it'll show me exactly what I see on the Alexa. I can look at, you know, if I click on recording codecs, I can come in here and see, okay, I have Arri RAW 4444. 4XQ, I have all 422, all these different options. And what I like about this is if I, let's say I put it on 422 HQ, I can set that and it tells me what my maximum sensor frames per rate is, right? I can confirm that and it'll load. And this lets you feel exactly what you want. Maybe I don't want to shoot, maybe I want to go Arri RAW. Once again, lets me know exactly where my project settings are. And it just gives me a chance now to get a feel for what it has. Recording resolution is very, very important. You know, if you want to do 16:9 to open gate in your simulator. And I'm not going to go through every single one of these because I've already done a video going through the menu systems of the Arri. But the great thing is you don't need to have an Arri in your hands. You can have one right here without ever having to spend a penny going and renting a system. And this lets you know you can configure it and get comfortable with the system without being on a set and really getting, you can either get up to speed if you've been a little rusty on it, or if you've never used one before, it gives you that peace of mind to get a little comfortable. Now, this isn't just the controls. You actually also have an Explorer, and I'm gonna click on this tab here. And this lets you see all the different parts of it. So you can see, this tells me what each of the buttons are, the user buttons, you know, the viewfinder connector. There's a lock button to lock it. There's a function button. All these things let me kind of get a feel for what I know. There's my L bus connector and my LPL mount, which is very, very good to know. Once again, all of my inputs here on the back, each of these are labeled if I go over them. So it's really just helpful. I mean, this really just keeps you up to speed with the cameras. And I'll be honest, I like coming here because I may go sometimes a few months in between shooting a project with an Alexa. And I just like to go, I just like to keep everything fresh and down. And you know, you can even come here to the viewfinder and it'll do the same thing with the viewfinder. It'll show you the jog wheel, the diopter, where your screen buttons are, a tally light. Just kind of let you see all of these little things that you want to go. So very, very useful, very, very handy. I really, really like this feature on the website. Now, the next thing that I think is going to be something that you really are going to use a lot in here after you basically get up to speed on the camera simulators is, I think what I found to be super, super helpful was this formats and data rate calculator. And let's take a look at it real quick. Okay, so here's the formats and data rate calculator. And this is awesome because I have used this on every single project I've ever had to shoot in Alexa. I've been working with my first ADs, with my DITs. I need to know my card situation. If we're out, sometimes we're out in places that we don't have access to a lot of computers and dumping situations. So I need to know before I go out there what I'm expecting to shoot and what formats make sense for me when I'm shooting. And this data rate calculator really, really helps me. I've used it on every project, and it's something that if you're shooting on an Arri, I recommend using because it's really, really helpful to have. So basically, it's pretty simple. You just come and select the camera. We've been using the Mini LF, so I'm going to do that. And then right away, I can start to see different settings to go. And what I love is I have a 1 terabyte compact drive card and I can see, okay, I want to shoot Arri RAW. All right, if I shoot Arri RAW at a 16:9, 3:8, 24 frames a second, I know I can get 53 minutes and 29 seconds on that card, right? However, let's say, all right, well, what's the difference if I shoot this at 4444XQ? Look at that, I get an hour and 19 minutes, you know, with the same settings. If I was on Arri, maybe I'm an Arri Raw and I want to see what Open Gate gives me. Let's see what Open Gate gives me. Well, I can only get 32 minutes at Open Gate. All these things make a difference because this allows you to truly maximize your set and make sure you show up with the media you need and keep everyone on budget as you're going. So this thing is really, really great. And it's pretty simple, man. I really just love how you get all this area. And I can see, you know, the other thing that's really great is if you look down here, it gives me a format preview. So I've got my sensor preview in OpenGate, but when I go back to 16 by 9, look at that. You can see how much of my sensor is being used, right? And what a clip preview size will look like. This is really, really great. So I know, okay, I'm gonna shoot 16 by 9, or let's go 239. All right, let's see what a OpenGate looks like. All right, the OpenGate, as y'all know, obviously uses all the sensor. So it's really great information to let us start making some of this creative decision-making for our budget and how we shoot, because you don't want to be on set with an Arri Alexa and not have enough data, because that would no one's going to be very nice with you. And if you're running a camera like this, you need to get up there and know exactly what you're kind of playing with and make sure you plan accordingly and show up on set with the appropriate amount of data. Now, the other thing that I think is just a really great tool to look at on here, the LUT generator and the Arri Look library are awesome, but I'm going to focus that on another video, is I really like this frame line and lens illumination tools. Let's take a look at that. All right, so here we are in the frame line and illumination tool. And this is another one of those great tools that lets you save money before you get on set, get comfortable with the camera. And more important, if you're a cinematographer, this is I love this tool with communicating with directors because we can kind of talk creatively about some of the ways we're gonna go with the camera. And I'll show you how that goes. You can see, once again, I can select the camera. We've been doing the Alexa Mini LF, let's do that. And you know, you see a couple of things here. One, it lets me know, am I shooting in RAW or ProRes? What are options? Let's say we want to shoot Open Gate, right? I'm going to shoot Open Gate here. And as you can see from this thing, you know, if I shoot 16 by 9, you can see that frame preview that we saw in the data rate one. Look at that. It's right here again. You see the amount of the sensor that the Alexa has. And then this white is the actual space that it's used. What's really nice, you can put a picture in there to get different options. I really like this car. I think that's cool. Let's do that. And you know, I'm gonna come back up here. I wanna say, I wanna shoot this thing in Open Gate just to get the full resolution. Now, we have an Open Gate sensor. We know we have it, but we're gonna wanna get some grid lines on there to help communicate what the vision of the story, because obviously we're not going to edit this thing in there. Now, if you look here in the aspect ratio, they're common aspect ratios, 1:33:1, 1:85:1, 2:1, you can see that. So let's say I do a 2:1, and boom, look at this right here. You get your frame line preview right there. And this is a great tool if you're a cinematographer communicating with a director to try and figure out what your aspect ratio is. You know, you can see, okay, well, okay, this is what a 2:39 looks like versus a 1:85. Give that idea, let your directors get in on the process and see what the process is. The great thing is, I can also come up here and let's say for some reason you want to do a custom aspect ratio. Maybe the story calls for it. You can come up here, dial it in, and let's say I want to do like a 3:1. Just get something really crazy in there. I'll apply it. And boom, look at that. It gives me a crazy 3:1. The other good thing about this is I can take this and, you know, let's say I want to have that crazy aspect ratio just be the bottom third. Or maybe I want it to be up a little bit on the top third, or I can center it. And you know, you can center it back up. And so I'm gonna center this back up. I got my 2:39, I kind of like that. So this is really, really nice. You can sit there, if I wanted to do a second frame, let's say I wanted to do this one at 2:1, I can do that. And all of a sudden you can see, maybe we have two different frame options in there. Maybe I wanna have a frame line that's got you know, more of a, let's say a 1:66:1, something really wide. And, you know, we're doing different formats, different things. We got that option. So you can put this on there, download it in your camera and have two options, you know, if we wanted to do that. The other thing that's really, and you can do a frame C, let's say we wanted to do a 2:1. You can now do up to 3 frame lines. So yeah, it's useful. It's really, really nice. And it lets you see all your aspects here. The other tool here that I think is really, really great, and it's in this frame and lens illumination settings, is the lens illumination guide. And this is one of those things that you need if you're shooting on an Alexa, especially a full frame, because full frame sensors tend to have way different types of vignetting depending on the lens. And if you look here, I can come over to my lens illumination guide, right? I'm gonna click this on open gate just so we can see our full open gate. And I can find different ways to shoot. And I think this is awesome. So look, if you look here, we have our Arri signature primes, right? I can click on that and you can see, let's say I do a signature prime at 75 and a 5.6. Well, look at that. You can see it versus a 1.8 where you get a little tiny bit of vignetting. Now the signature primes, even if I go on an 18 millimeter at 1.8, you get a little vignetting. At 5.6, it disappears. 4, it just gives you that great thing. Now the signature primes I know are going to be great. They're designed for the Arri, but let's say I want to go for cooks. I can click on some cooks here, right? And boom, look at that S4 at an F2. Maybe at an F4, I can see what it looks like at an F4. And you know, I know that an S4i might be a little much. I'm gonna go to an S7 and you can see, oh, okay. I really like cooks. If I wanna use this camera with cooks, I better make sure I get S7s, right? And you can see that different thing. Are you a Zeiss person? Well, that's no problem. Let's go over to Zeiss. You can see the different Zeiss lenses that you get here. Now, if I know I have a Zeiss 18 millimeter, I'm gonna have problems on an Alexa open gate full frame. I know I can go to 35 and be okay. But this is also helpful because once again, I can come back up here and let's say, all right, let's see what this looks like at a 239. All right, well now I can see what the vignetting looks like at this situation if I crop in. So once again, really, really useful tool. I think everyone should use this. I love this because it's the chance to play with different lenses and different sensors and see how those lenses are gonna interact with those. And you don't have to spend the money to get the camera there. It's a great way to get that initial footprint and that initial foot in the door as you begin to build your project. So I hope that was helpful. This is a site you really just need to investigate yourself if you're doing it. I would recommend taking the time, this is just sort of a rough introduction, take the time and just play with it because this is a great site. Arri is such a good brand. They're so helpful and their tools are great. If you haven't checked out the site, I recommend doing it. Yeah, guys, I hope that helped. Please leave me any comments down below. If you like what you see, subscribe, that helps me out. Yeah, guys, go out there, keep on shooting. Yeah, and I'll talk to you soon.